If we go back about 7 years ago, I can guarantee you all, I'd be the last person in this room to stand up and do a talk. These days, I'll be on stage for an hour, 1,000 people in the audience, love every minute of it. So what changed? Well, after I achieved my success in business, I realised there were some things I was doing really, really well in life, and some things I was doing badly. Then I thought about speaking. When I'm asked to do a presentation, what do I start thinking? I'll forget my words, I'll look nervous, I'll sound nervous, the audience won't like it. The mistake I was making is I was thinking about everything going wrong rather than everything going right. As soon as I changed it and started to think about doing presentations and them going well and being valuable to the audience, the fear level started to go down. This is why communication matters. Not just to other people, but the communication you're having with yourself in your head. Because the communication you have with yourself in your head controls the communication that you have with others anyway. It determines if you're coming across desperate in a sales situation or if you're coming across confident and really interested in what's important for them. So there's two things in life about everything we do, and that's skill set and mindset. The skill set is what you do, when you do it, how you do it. It's all the how-to stuff. But the mindset, very often the missing piece. This is the belief, confidence, motivation, the compelling goal. Most people know what they should be doing, but they don't do it because they don't feel comfortable to do it, because of the mindset. So the thing with mindset, the big thing with communication and how we communicate with ourselves, is that us as leaders or business owners or managers, whatever, have got a mindset, but so have all of our team members. They've all got mindsets going on. So have our customers, our suppliers, and you've got to take that into account when you're communicating with them, when you're talking to them, when you're doing different things. We greatly manifest all of the outcomes we get in life based on how we think about them beforehand. It's absolutely true. That's the way it is. That party could be a business meeting. It could be an appraisal. It could be a networking event. It could be a conference event like this. Some of you came to this looking forward to it, thinking I'm going to meet a lot of people, it's going to be great. Some of you came to it feeling nervous about it, thinking about it. And I know that because I used to be that nervous person years ago. That used to be me. The confidence is really a degree of certainty about an outcome we'll get or how we'll perform in a given situation. Now, I know that's a bit of a mouthful there, but it really breaks it down great. Because when you say, I don't have confidence in X, you can say, well, that's just because my degree of certainty about how I'll perform or the outcome I'll get isn't there. So what do I need to do? Skill set or mindset or both? What do I need to develop? I need to develop one or the other. I need to develop both. Expectation of a good outcome changes the way your mind engages you in action. A lot of people tell you, and a lot of successful people tell you, you need a vision. I don't think you do. I think you need two visions. You need an internal vision, or I call it an ego vision, and you need an external vision, which is the one you tell other people, the non-ego version. Because you want, when you think about where you want to be, where you want your business to be, where you want your life to be, when you visualize that and think about that, which is what all successful people do, that's going to make you smile on the inside. That's going to be something very ego-driven, unfortunately. So when you think about it, you go, oh, that's going to be so cool. That's going to be absolutely fantastic. But it's not necessarily the sort of thing you share with someone if they say, what are your goals and ambitions? Because they might not think it sounds that great. When things don't go too well, they tend to respond rather than react or overreact. So we've got two options in a situation generally. Do we respond, which is logical, or do we react, which is emotional? So I'll often say to an audience, you got back to your room tonight and picked up your voicemail, customer's phoned up, they've got a complaint, do you respond or react? A response would be, oh, that doesn't sound too good, we better give them a call, if it's something we've done wrong, we better put this right. A reaction would be, oh, then again, they're always ordering the wrong stuff, they've probably messed up the order again. They're a pain. Because if you react, even though you try to calm down when you make that call, you're going to come across differently. The words will be different, the tonality will be different, the pauses between the words will be different. And it's going to make them react different again. And this is all the reason why communication matters. Because where we're going will change it. Now, successful people and successful leaders, they communicate well. They communicate well with themselves inside, which is mainly what I've been talking about today, and with others. They communicate as experts. They communicate well. They take care of the other person. What's the other person need? What's most important to that person? And then they're confident and definite in telling them that they can definitely help them with that. So this whole presentation isn't about learning anything new. It's about unlearning all the rubbish that you've picked up since you were 4 years old that started you to get to doubt yourself, that you could do something, and all these sorts of things. And it's not just happening with you, it's happening with your suppliers, it's happening with your customers, it's happening with your team members, it's happening with your staff, it's happening with everyone. We're all human beings, and we've all got this stuff going on in our heads all the time. So lots of people that don't look like they're good people, or we're labourers, lazy or stuff like that, we need to take that extra couple of minutes of time to get the lower detail, to find out what's really going on, so that in turn we can help them, and then they'll be better for us as well. Positivity and inspiration is absolutely everywhere. Everywhere, if you look for it. Thanks for listening.